Welcome back, everyone, to more WWF Raw. Let's take you back now. Oh, my goodness. Here we go. Here come the Godwinns. Henry and Phineas, former tag team champions, and last week they lost the tag team titles to LOD. However, they think they were robbed, JR, because they tried to intentionally get disqualified. Here, take it. Let's take a look at this.
Completely violating the spirit of the rule. Oh. Henry Godwin delivered a slob drop on the referee, Earl Hebner. And baby Earl got planted, but there was no disqualification because the other referees did not see it.
And look at this. Animal, who was injured, came back and got into the fray. Animal, a house of fire on both Godwinns.
But it would be another mistake that we're going to see here in a few moments. We thought it was going to be the doomsday device. Cletus interrupted the situation, but right here, you're going to see Cletus with that horseshoe momentarily really turn this thing around.
Yeah, watch this.
He turned it around, all right, but the wrong way. What's Animal? No!
Cletus knocked out of the ring. And Phineas was there with Animal. Now watch this.
Watch Hawk. Animal positions Phineas just right, knowing where his partner of 14 years was positioned.
And then the other official coming in and counting to three. It wasn't the original official. It wasn't the referee who was dropped or slop dropped, so to speak.
It was Mike Chioda.
So LOD became tag team champions just last week. Of course, we saw them earlier tonight. And look what the Godwinns did to their own relations. Look at this. Cletus is being hammered there by Phineas. And then watch
this. A little family feud. Cletus got a broken nose and a concussion out of that slop drop.
That's the kind of human beings we have in the ring right now. And there is Mike Chioda. The official. Ooh, wait a
minute. Oh, come on.
Oh, wait a minute.
Nobody respect anybody for anything anymore.
And we've got the roar, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. Here we go. It's DLA. And look at those magnificent Titan spikes.
Remember, kids, you should always wear your helmet.
And don't ride your motorcycles in the house.
No, that's for sure. Unbelievable, these magnificent Titan bikes and the Godwinns were set to take
on. Hey, wait a minute.
Oh, wait a minute. Here we go. Here we go. It's 4-on-2. DLA is going to teach the Godwinns a lesson. They don't care.
It's a little bit of martial law here. The strong will survive in the WWF.
And the rest
of them just get the hell beat out of them.
And the Godwinns are getting just that. The Godwinns are getting a hell beat out of them by DLA.
And the Godwinns just threatened the referee, and he's not going out of his way to stop this.
The Truth Commission.
What?
The Truth Commission, here they come.
And now the Godwinns got some help. 4 Truth Commission, 2 Godwinns. That makes it 6-on-4 advantage Truth Commission and the Hawk Farmers.
And look at all of this mayhem here. Look at that monster, that huge monster over there.
And what's it going to be like here next week when Bret Hart defends a WWF title against Ken Shamrock?
What's it going to be like in the Survivor Series? Oh, my goodness.
It is chaotic. This is mayhem.
Look at this huge guy.
The interrogator, this big giant, this monster is dominant.
The interrogator. Oh, no, a huge boot right there to the kisser. And the Truth Commission and the Godwinns now pretty much clean house. And they're giving this interrogator a wide berth. As well they should. We have what? Mankind.
So you think you've seen madness. You don't know the meaning of the word. Because mankind is the master of madness, of mayhem, of malice, even cruelty. And if The Undertaker has qualms about fighting his own brother, then rest assured, I have no such principles. Because if it were my own sweet, dear, decrepit grandmother who dropped an innocent kid like Dude Love on his head, then the old bag would go down. So, Kane, I want to make myself clear. I'll fight you anywhere, anytime, anyhow, and you will be mine. Mine. All mine. Have a nice day.